Samson Switchblade. The Samson Switchblade sounds like a sports car with seating for two, a luggage capacity of 50 pounds, and the power-to-weight ratio of a Corvette. It's only when you notice the extendable wings and the tail, as well as the Dynon avionics gear, that you realize it's also a capable flying machine. It is classified as an experimental home-built aircraft and can reach speeds of up to 180 miles per hour with a maximum altitude of 13,000 feet. Its skybird hybrid drive and fly systems provide a range of up to 450 miles with an integrated vehicle parachute that keeps you safe in the air and front and rear crumple zones and rollover protection that keeps you safe on the ground. And the best part is that it was recently deemed safe for flight testing by the FAA, so it will likely be on the road or somewhere in the clouds in short order. You can buy this flying machine for around $150,000. Jetracer. The Zapata company introduced the turbo-powered personal flying machine, the Jetracer. Franky Zapata's latest invention is essentially a vertical takeoff and landing aircraft capable of reaching 155 miles per hour and a maximum altitude of around 10,000 feet while carrying one passenger. The Jetracer does not have any electric motors, only 10 jet engines that provide both power and speed. The aircraft itself is built on a lightweight and modular chassis, allowing it to meet a variety of requirements. In other words, it can be used commercially, civilly, and militarily, and it can even be controlled remotely. All of its critical systems are built with a high level of redundancy and safety in mind, but sadly, there is no word on the pricing or the availability as of yet. In the meantime, if you're enjoying the video so far, show your support by smashing that like button and stay tuned for the bonus flying machine at the end of this video. You really don't want to miss this out. SureFly. At first glance, the Workhorse SureFly personal aircraft appears to be a drone, but it's actually a two-seater that aims to reinvent the helicopter. It is propelled by 8 independent motors that turn 8 carbon fiber propellers and are powered by a gasoline engine. There is a battery backup in case something goes wrong, but if that also fails, ballistic parachutes are provided for all 4 passengers. This personal flying machine has a range of 70 miles and a running time of 1 hour. The company's initial goal is to serve as an air taxi, flying maximum distances of 70 miles, but the company's broader vision includes autonomous flight capable of transporting up to 400 pounds, providing benefits not only in city commutes, but also in agriculture and emergency response. Workhorse is currently taking pre-orders for the SureFly with a target price of less than $200,000. Ryse Recon. The Recon eVTOL is marked as a buy-and-fly ultralight aircraft that farmers and ranchers can use right away without requiring pilot's license. The vehicle has a top speed of 63 miles per hour and a range of up to 25 miles on a single charge. This personal flying machine is also capable of operating on both land and water with low-cost maintenance that keeps it reasonably priced. It uses 6 independent propulsion systems with removable and rechargeable batteries to provide power. The production model is expected to start at $150,000 with customer deliveries beginning around 2023. Lilium Jet. The new 7-seater Lilium Jet was originally developed by the company as a regional shuttle service for sustainable, high-speed transportation. Its quiet vertical takeoff allows this flying machine to access more landing sites and provides the opportunity to build higher network density, avoiding the need for expensive ground infrastructure. The electric aircraft has a projected cruise speed of 175 miles per hour at 10,000 feet, can easily cover more than 150 miles thanks to its power reserve. It uses 36 individual electric-ducted fans for propulsion, with wings and fuselage providing most of the lift during flight. Cavorite X5. Horizon Aircraft's new Cavorite X5 prototype is without a doubt one of the most visually appealing flying machines we've seen this year. But the craft is more than just a showpiece. It also has an impressive flying range and enough space for 5 adults, making it one of the more spatial options in development. The aircraft uses a hybrid electric power terrain for lift. The LSV8 engine provides the majority of the power, allowing it to reach speeds of up to 215 miles per hour and travel up to 310 miles on a single charge with a full load of passengers and cargo. And if you're flying solo, with no passengers or cargo, you can increase the distance to a very respectable 625 miles. For now, the Cavorite X5 is still in the concept stages, but Horizon is currently at work on a 1:6 scale model with hopes of testing a half-scale aircraft within the next 12 months. If all goes according to plan, the startup hopes to start selling a low-volume production kit by 2024. BlackFly. The BlackFly from Opener may appear to be a UFO at first glance, but it's actually a personal electric vertical takeoff and landing aircraft. For maximum safety, it is outfitted with triple module redundant flight systems, control surface, and sensors. This personal flying machine is capable of takeoff and landing in small areas while traveling distances of up to 35 miles at speeds of up to 75 miles per hour. The ultralight single-passenger joystick-controlled aircraft does not require formal licensing to fly in the United States, but the company does require owners to take the FAA private pilot examination, as well as its own training. Jetpack Aviation recently unveiled its latest jetpack prototype, and it's called the JB-10. It enables humans to soar up to 10,000 feet in the air at speeds of up to 68 miles per hour as it draws power from 2 diesel-powered jet turbine engines. And while flying, users lean forward to move or speed up and lean back to slow down. The right handle controls thrust and throttle, and the left handle governs how much you spin. That's not all. It can even be equipped with an automatic inflation system, one that releases a floating bag in seconds if you were to hit the water in an emergency landing.